Hello everyone and welcome to Boundless Dentistry. In this video we'll talk about dental implants, the different components that are present in dental implants, and then we'll talk about function of each of these components in detail. So let's get started. Now firstly, talking about some basic facts about dental implant. Dental implant is a dental prosthesis that is used to replace a missing teeth. The missing teeth can be present either due to some caries problems, periodontal problems, trauma, malignancy and congenital causes. There are many causes that are related to missing teeth. So dental implant is one of those options which can be used to replace missing teeth. It is a surgical procedure because there are some methods to replace missing teeth which are non-surgical. So dental implant is a surgical procedure. The implant is placed in the oral tissue beneath mucosa and periosteal layers. As you can see in this picture, this is the base of the implant. It is placed below the soft tissue and inside the bone. So this is the location of where dental implant is placed. And when the dental implant is placed in the bone, it is fixed and it forms a union with the implant and bone. And this is known as osseointegration. The process where the implant is embedded in the bone and a union is formed, that is known as osseointegration. Now, dental implant can also be used to support for other dental prostheses as well. First, the fixture is placed. As you can see in this diagram, this is the fixture which is placed in the bone, and then on top of that, the dental prosthesis is placed. We'll discuss each of these components of a dental implant in detail. Now, when you have place this fixture inside the bone, there are certain period of months of healing period that is required, because for that osseointegration has to occur, and the healing period provides that much of months so that osseointegration can occur, and then finally a prosthesis is placed over the fixture. Now, classifying the components of dental implants, there are basically two classes. The first is the main components of dental implant, and second are accessories of the dental implant. In main components, we have the fixture, abutment and the superstructure, also known as the artificial crown, which you can see in this diagram. The accessories of dental implant includes two categories. The first is surgical and the second is prosthetic. In surgical, we have cover screw and gingival former, and in prosthetic, we have implant analog and impression post. In this diagram, you can see all of these structures which I have just mentioned now, and now we'll discuss in detail of each component individually. Now firstly, talking about the fixture of dental component, it is that part of the implant which is placed inside the bone. This is the fixture you can see. Surgically placed in the bone, it is also known as implant body. The fixture itself consists of three parts. First is the body, crest module, collar, and then there is apex of the fixture as well. Firstly, talking about the body of fixture, it is cylindrical or it is tapered cylindrically. There are different variations to the shape of the fixture. It can be either smooth or non-threaded and threaded. So there are two categories of fixture. Either it is non-threaded, also known as smooth, or it has threaded surface. As you can see, this is a threaded fixture and this is smooth. You can clearly see the difference between the two types of fixture. It can also be either solid or it can have holes. Now these holes, as you can see in this diagram, it provides some space for the bone growth to occur. The threaded structure is more suitable for placement of implant, and the threads that are present in the fixture, it helps to maximize initial contact with the bone and helps to dissipate the stresses which are placed on occlusally. Now if you magnify this fixture, a detailed structure you can see over here, this is pitch. Pitch is defined as the distance between the threads. These individual lines you can see, these are threads, and pitch is the distance between these threads. The greater the pitch is and more thread, the greater the surface area for the fixture is present. And you can also appreciate that this is the depth of the thread and this is the width of the thread. Now these shapes can be either square or in buttress form. Now talking about the second part of the fixture, that is crest module. Crest module is basically that part of the fixture which provides connection with the abutment. You can see this is the crest module and it provides connection with the abutment that will be eventually placed on top of it. The role of crest module is to provide resistance occlusal loads and precise fitting of abutment on the fixture. You can see here the abutment will be placed and this crest module helps in resistance to axial occlusal load and precise fitting of abutment. The last part of fixture is implant collar. Implant collar is basically the most superior part of the fixture, as you can see here. This is the implant collar. Now there are two types of implant. Either the implant is submerged in the bone and below soft tissue, or it is non-submerged. Now in submerged implant, the height of implant collar is around 0.5 to 1 millimeters. For non-submerged implant, the height of this implant collar is 3 to 5 mm. Now what is the role of implant collar? The role of implant collar is basically functional remodeling of bone and improves abutment fixture interface. Now talking about the second part of dental implant, that is the abutment which is placed on top of the fixture. Now abutment is basically a screw directly placed on the implant. On this abutment, the prosthesis is eventually placed. You can see this is the fixture and here the abutment is inserted, and on that top of the abutment we have the eventual prosthesis that will be placed and will be visible clinically. Now in cemented restoration, sometimes the restoration can either be screwed or cemented, but in case of cemented restoration, the abutment is shaped like a conventional crown. You can see in this diagram as well. The length of a typical abutment can vary from 1 to 10 millimeters. Now importantly, talking about the size of the abutment, the size of the abutment is dependent upon the vertical distance present between the base of the fixture and the opposing teeth, and aesthetics also play a vital role in deciding the size of the abutment. For anterior aesthetics, 2 to 3 mm of subgingival porcelain is required, but for posteriors it can be either at or below the gingival margin. As you can see, this is the abutment which is placed, and since it's present anteriorly, it is 2 to 3 mm subgingivally present. Now the next part of dental implant is superstructure, which is actually visible in the oral cavity. It is the prosthesis fabricated with support of dental implants. You can see we talked about the fixture which is here, then we talked about abutment, and now on top of abutment will be the superstructure which will be placed. It is also known as the artificial tooth. Now the superstructure is of three types. It can be the fixed, which consists of crown and bridges. It can be the removable, which consists of overdenture, and it can be either fixed detachable prosthesis, which is hybrid dentures. So there are different varieties of superstructure which is present. In this diagram you can also appreciate the fixture is present, then you have the abutment, and on top of abutment we have the superstructure which is visible in the oral cavity. So far we have talked about the main components of dental implant, that is fixture, abutment and superstructure. Now talking about some accessory structures of dental implant, firstly we'll talk about the surgical parts that are present. First is the screw. After you have placed the implant in the bone, then on top of the fixture we place the screw, and this screw helps during healing period of bone, because some period of healing time is required so that osseointegration can occur, and this screw is placed on top of the fixture. Now the implant surgery can be performed in two types, either it's one stage or it is two stage. Now in two stage, the screw is placed and the soft tissue is sutured on top of it, and then on second stage, in two stage implant placement, the screw is removed and the abutment is placed on top of it. But on the other hand, when one stage implant procedure is taken under consideration, the screw is placed, but the function of screw now is to minimize loading that will be present on that abutment or the dental implant. Now talking about the second accessory dental implant component, that is gingival former. Now in two stage implant procedure, only then is the gingival former used. Now when the screw is removed, the gingival former is placed, as you can see in this clinical picture. This gingival former extends above the soft tissue. You can also appreciate this as well. Now what is the function of gingival former? The gingival former is placed so that the gingival cuff can form around the dental implant. A contour of gingiva is formed. Now after talking about the accessory surgical components, now we'll talk about the prosthetic accessory components of dental implant. First is the implant analog. The implant analog is basically a replica of dental implant. It's not for implantation inside the bone. No, that's not the case. It's similar to the fixture, but it helps in forming the exact replica of this fixture in the lab. Now abutment is placed on top of this fixture which is created in the lab, and this is known as implant replica. So this is an implant analog. Now the second prosthetic dental implant component is impression coping, or you can also call it impression post. Now this provides spatial relation of endosteal implant to alveolar ridge and adjacent teeth along with other structures that are present. Now this post is attached to the fixture. Now what is the role of this post that is present? This facilitates transfer and intraoral location of the implant, the exact location of the intraoral implant where the implant will be placed, and this location is replicated in lab. You can appreciate the procedure of impression post in this clinical picture as well. Now, lastly, summarizing the function of all of the dental components that we've discussed so far. Firstly, talking about implant fixture, the body goes into the bone and it retains the implant structure. Second, crest module, it's the part of the fixture that provides connection with the abutment, resistance to axial loading and precise fitting of abutment. Third is the collar. Collar allows functional remodeling of bone, improves abutment fixture interface and prevents exposure of surface coating. This is the function of each of the part present in implant fixture. Secondly, talking about abutment, abutment retains the superstructure. Third, we have the superstructure. Superstructure is that part of the dental implant that is visible in the oral cavity. It provides a site of attachment for dental prosthesis. Fourth is cover screw. Cover screw covers the fixture during the healing period so that osseointegration can occur. It facilitates suturing of during two-stage implant procedure, or if in one-stage implant procedure is used, it helps in minimizing loading. Fifth is gingival former. Gingival former is used only in two-stage implant procedure. It is present above the soft tissue and facilitates formation of gingival cuff around the implant. Sixth is implant analog. It replicates dental implant in lab using master cast. And seventh is impression coating, provides spatial relation between endosteal implant and alveolar ridge, adjacent teeth and other structures, facilitates transfer of exact location of intraoral implant to the lab. So this was all about each component that is present in dental implant, starting from the main components and accessory components. Main components mainly consisting of fixture, abutment and superstructure. Then we talked about accessory structures divided into two parts. We have the surgical one, which consists of cover screw and gingival former, and then prosthetics, which consist of impression post and impression analog. So I hope this video was useful for you, and if you like this video, please like, share, subscribe and press the bell icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you next time.